When I first reviewed the 2018 iPad Pro, I concluded that it was not a computer replacement, like Apple's famous "What's a computer" ad claimed. I mentioned that it won't replace a laptop until Apple wanted it to. And after spending 2 weeks with Apple's brand new iPadOS, which is completely separate from iOS, I can tell you now that you can legitimately replace your laptop with the new iPad Pro. Before we get into those changes, let me give you a quick rundown of what makes the 2018 iPad Pro stand out from the crowd. It's the first iPad ever to pack a rounded display that makes it look unique and modern. It's the first iPad ever to have no visible form of authentication. Touch ID is gone and there's no notch for Face ID, so it seems to unlock magically, even while it's upside down. The new straight edge design is completely unique, made to support wireless charging on the newly updated Apple Pencil, which holds onto the iPad magnetically for storage, and packs a new double tap feature that greatly boosts productivity. The new smart keyboard folio is perfectly sleek and makes it feel like you're using a laptop. And if you don't like it, there are awesome alternatives from Bridge and Logitech that work very well. It packs 4 high quality speakers that make the rest of the iPad lineup sound like Android tablets, and the display feels buttery smooth with the ProMotion 120Hz technology. For the downsides, the headphone jack is now gone, but it's not a big deal since USB-C adapters are so cheap on Amazon. It's also expensive, starting at $800, but now that iPadOS is coming, we definitely think it's worth it over the other iPads, especially at Amazon's sale price of just $700. And if you're like me and you want to make sure to protect your investment, you have until 60 days after your purchase, or 45 for smartphones, to buy an incredibly affordable warranty from Upsy, our sponsor for this video. Upsy works with nationwide certified repair shops and helps buyers in the United States save up to 70% on a warranty compared to retailers. And they make it incredibly easy to make a claim by having real people available on the phone 24/7, 365 days a year. And they store your receipt and all the info you'll need right in your Upsy account. And you can use the link in the video description below with the code MAXTECH today for 10% off your first warranty purchase. So back to the iPad Pro, let's discuss all the awesome new changes coming with iPadOS that allow you to replace your laptop. First off, getting USB-C on this iPad Pro didn't really mean much since it was so limited, not allowing you to connect external drives. But now, we finally have external storage support that works really well. You can connect anything from a flash drive to a hard drive or SD card, and transfer various types of files to the iPad's local storage folder. You can even connect multiple drives at once and transfer files between them. You can zip and unzip files and folders. And if you use Split View, you can drag and drop files directly from a hard drive to an app like LumaFusion, and it'll all work without importing the file to Camera Roll or the iPad's local storage. We have a full guide on external storage which you can check out at the end of this video. Now there's actually a big list of iPads that support iPadOS, but the 2018 iPad Pro and its USB-C port is the way to go for external storage support. The old Lightning port isn't able to supply enough power to be able to drive various storage drives, so it requires a special camera kit adapter which plugs into power. And even then, some drives still won't work. So the convenience of USB-C is well worth it on the iPad Pro. One thing that's pretty amazing is SMB server support, which works incredibly well, allowing you to connect to hard drives or servers over a Wi-Fi connection so you can view and transfer your archived files. With iPadOS, you can now open multiple instances of the same app in Split View, like 2 Notes apps or 2 Files apps, to make transferring files easier. And it even works with third-party apps that support it. There's also a bunch of new multitasking features and gestures that make the iPad much easier to use, like easier ways to select text, and finally an undo gesture that doesn't require you to shake your iPad. Safari has seen some awesome new updates like automatic desktop mode that's optimized for touch, and there's a new download manager, similar to what you get on the Mac. In the settings, you can easily change the download location to wherever you want. We were even able to download a PowerPoint file from Google and edit it using Keynote. Perhaps the best part is that iPadOS is getting exactly the same physical keyboard shortcuts that we're already used to on macOS, both for use within Safari and basically everywhere else on the iPad, so making the switch is much easier. And if you're using the on-screen keyboard, you'll be able to pinch it to shrink it down and move it anywhere you'd like, as well as use the new swipe keyboard, which works incredibly well. It's even better for Apple Pencil users, since input latency has been reduced from an industry-leading 20 milliseconds to a very impressive 9 milliseconds. There's also a new tool palette which can be easily moved around so it doesn't get in your way, and it's much easier to mark up a page. Just drag from the corner of the screen using the Apple Pencil. From here, you can mark it up and share it, or tap the full page button at the top to be able to scroll through the entire page. And you can even grab the scroll bar and scroll up and down without having to swipe. And it doesn't stop there. Apple has finally added Bluetooth mouse support, but you don't actually get a cursor like you do on the Mac. you're basically just moving your finger around and clicking the mouse to perform a touch gesture, so it's not the best solution. However, it does fix a huge issue with external monitor mirroring. Before, if you used an external display, you'd still have to touch the iPad to navigate. But now, you can use a Bluetooth mouse and keyboard and set your iPad to the side. Not only that, but if you have a Mac running macOS Catalina, you can use the iPad as a secondary display to do things like wirelessly draw directly into the full macOS Photoshop app using the iPad. On top of that, the iPad Pro outperforms the rest of Apple's latest iPad lineup by a massive margin, so you're gonna have no performance issues in basically any app or game you try out. I previously stated that people should just buy the 2019 iPad Air because the iPad Pro's performance was so limited due to software, but I've completely changed my mind now that iPadOS is coming out. Having USB-C in this level of performance guarantees the best possible support for apps and features for years to come, and its unique design, awesome quad speakers, and the new Apple Pencil make it feel unique and special compared to the other iPads. I'd have to say that paying only $700 with Prime shipping for this iPad Pro, or even $900 for the 256GB model is well worth the price, especially if you're trying to replace a much more expensive laptop. I definitely recommend anyone looking at the 2019 iPad Air to just save some more cash and buy the iPad Pro, because with iPadOS, it's finally become what Apple has envisioned it to be. If you enjoyed this long-term review, make sure to smash that like button, click the circle above to subscribe, and make sure to check out one of those two videos right there. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.